So welcome to my vlog Where To? Galicia part 2. Last time we talked about the northern part of Galicia, now we talk about the southern part. The west coast of Galicia has so much to offer. There are so many places where you can go where almost no people wear super nice waves. I will tell you just a few spots, the other one you have to discover by yourself, but just a few spots and which are really worth to go it. The first thing what I can recommend is Niminha. Niminha is a small, really small, it's not a village, it's more like three houses. There's nothing around, but there are amazing waves. When the swell is the right direction, you can have amazing, huge, huge, big, big waves, which are barreling sometimes. So it's also for beginners, but more in the front, the white water. It's not easy to surf your first green wave because the green waves are pretty small and pretty hollow in there. It's more for advanced and professionals. There's nothing around. There's one small restaurant, there's one surf camp, and there are some small possibilities to park. It means when you're coming in your camper van, you need to have a lot of luck that you can get a parking space, because if not, there's no possibility to park, or you have to walk a long way. But if you're lucky, you can park just directly in front of the beach. There are almost no people from other countries, only locals, a little bit of localism because it's a really good wave, but the people are all friendly. If you are friendly and respect the locals, you won't have problems and you can surf it. Check it out, awesome spot, just nature around and really calm and quiet. Awesome, awesome spot. From Niminha, the next one which is really recommendable is Louro. Louro is a small tourist town, tourist more for the Spanish tourists. There are a lot of restaurants, bars and everything you need for a nightlife. And there is an awesome, awesome, awesome beach with a mountain, just white sands, blue water. And you can park with your camperman pretty close to the beach, not really close to the beach, but pretty close. And there are some waves which are super nice. It's a fast hollow wave, more advanced and professional. But for the night, I would recommend to enjoy the bars and restaurants in town because there's a lot of stuff going on. There in the high season, there's a lot of party going on, a lot of people from all around Spain. And it's a pretty nice area to be there. The next one is a small beach called Rio Sierra. This is a really small beach, but there's a parking place just in front of the beach. There are a lot of campers and surfers which are just camping there or stay there and enjoying their time. You can just park there, there's a restaurant close to it. There's not much going on, there's just that restaurant and that beach. But the waves are pretty amazing. It depends on the swell, but if there's a bigger swell, you will have amazing waves. It's for everyone, like for beginners, advanced and professionals. You will have the bigger ones and the faster waves a little bit more outside and the smaller waves just in the front. Check it out, there's an special vibe in it, and you can enjoy it. And if you just cruise around a little bit, you will find a lot of other places which I won't talk about, but you can discover it. One of the most favorite tourist areas in Galicia is La Lanzada. La Lanzada is a very wide stretched white beach with blue water, a beach break with big waves when the swell is big, and smaller waves for the beginners when there's a smaller swell. But it's for everyone, like beginners, advanced and professionals. You can have a lot of fun there. There are a lot of small beaches all around there, hidden beaches. You can sleep at, the people won't say anything, and you will meet a lot of other surfers and campers. There are two towns close to it where you can enjoy food, beer and party. There are a lot of camping sites around. Even if you have children or dogs, you can go to the camping sites and you're close to the beach. And yeah, you will have different opportunities to surf, different directions, as well as a little bit more south or north. You can just choose your spot you want to have, because there are some beaches a little bit more west face, a little bit more north face, a little bit more south face. It's a super nice area. There are some fishing towns there, you can go for fresh fish. There's a lot of going on in the summertime, and it's a really nice place to stay there. That's it for Galicia with the places I told you. But what I can tell you is take your camper van and really cruise down the coastline. Don't take the highways, just go close to the sea. the whole coastline by your car, and you will discover so many beautiful places to take photos, to go for food, to go for a cafe, or just to surf or stay for the night. It is the most amazing area in Spain. It's very, very worth to go to Galicia, even if it's a far way, but you will enjoy it. See you the next time.